Privacy? Privacy, or the right to enjoy freedom from unauthorized intrusion, is the negative right of all human beings. Privacy is defined as the right to be left alone, to be free from secret surveillance, or unwanted disclosure of personal data or information by government, corporation, or individual, dictionary.com. In this lecture we will define privacy loosely, as the right to control access to personal information. Supporters of privacy posit that it is a necessity for human dignity and individuality and a key element in the quest for happiness. According to Bassa, in the course titled A Gift of Fire, Social, Legal and Ethical Issues for Computing and the Internet, privacy is the ability to control information about oneself as well as the freedom from surveillance from being followed, tracked, watched, and being eavesdropped on. In this regard, ignoring privacy rights often leads to encroachment on natural rights. Privacy, or even the thought that one has this right, leads to peace of mind and can provide an environment of solitude. This solitude can allow people to breathe freely in a space that is free from interference and intrusion. According to Richards and Solove, legal scholar William Prosser argued that privacy cases can be classified into four related torts, namely: intrusion, this can be viewed as encroachment, physical or otherwise, on one's liberty/solitude in a highly offensive way. Privacy facts, making public, private information about someone that is of no legitimate concern to anyone. False light, making public false and highly offensive information about others. Appropriation, stealing someone's identity, name, likeness, to gain advantage without the permission of the individual. Intrusion, this can be viewed as encroachment, physical or otherwise, on one's liberty/solitude in a highly offensive way. Privacy facts, making public, private information about someone that is of no legitimate concern to anyone. False light, making public false and highly offensive information about others. Appropriation, stealing someone's identity, name, likeness, to gain advantage without the permission of the individual. Technology, the digital age, the internet and social media have redefined privacy, however, as surveillance is no longer limited to a certain predefined space and location. An understanding of the problems and dangers of privacy in the digital space is therefore the first step to privacy control. While there can be clear distinctions between informational privacy and physical privacy, as pointed out earlier, intrusion can be both physical and otherwise. This lecture will focus on informational privacy, which is the ability to control access to personal information. We examine privacy issues in the social media context, focusing primarily on personal information and the ability to control external influences. We suggest that breach of informational privacy can impact solitude, the right to be left alone, intimacy, the right not to be monitored, and anonymity, the right to have no public personal identity and by extension physical privacy impacted. The right to control access to facts or personal information, in our view, is a natural, inalienable right, and everyone should have control over who see their personal information and how it is disseminated. In May 2019, the General Data Protection Regulation, GDPR, clearly outlined that it is unlawful to process personal data without the consent of the individual, subject. It is a legal requirement under the GDPR that privacy notices be given to individuals that outline how their personal data will be processed and the conditions that must be met that make the consent valid. These are: freely given, an individual must be given a genuine choice when providing consent, and it should generally be unbundled from other terms and conditions. For example, access to a service should not be conditional upon consent being given. Specific and informed, this means that data subjects should be provided with information as to the identity of the controllers, the specific purposes, types of processing, as well as being informed of their right to withdraw consent at any time. Explicit and unambiguous, the data subject must clearly express their consent, for example, by actively ticking a box which confirms they are giving consent. Pre-ticked boxes are insufficient. Under 13s, children under the age of 13 cannot provide consent, and it is therefore necessary to obtain consent from their parents. Freely given, an individual must be given a genuine choice when providing consent, and it should generally be unbundled from other terms and conditions, for example, access to a service should not be conditional upon consent being given. Specific and informed, this means that data subjects should be provided with information as to the identity of the controllers, the specific purposes, types of processing, as well as being informed of their right to withdraw consent at any time. Explicit and unambiguous, the data subject must clearly express their consent, for example, by actively ticking a box which confirms they are giving consent. Pre-ticked boxes are insufficient. Under 13s, children under the age of 13 cannot provide consent and it is therefore necessary to obtain consent from their parents. Arguments can be made that privacy is a cultural, universal necessity for harmonious relationships among human beings and creates the boundaries for engagement and disengagement. Privacy can also be viewed as instrumental good because it is a requirement for the development of certain kinds of human relationships, intimacy and trust. However, achieving privacy is much more difficult in light of constant surveillance and the inability to determine the levels of interaction with various publics. Some critics argue that privacy provides protection against antisocial behaviors such as trickery, disinformation and fraud, and is thought to be a universal right. However, privacy can also be viewed as relative as privacy rules may differ based on several factors such as climate, religion, technological advancement and political arrangements. The need for privacy is an objective reality though it can be viewed as culturally rational where the need for personal privacy is viewed as relative based on culture. One example is the push by the government, businesses and Singaporeans to make Singapore a smart nation. According to GovTech 2018 reports there is a push by the government in Singapore to harness the data New Gold to develop systems that can make life easier for its people. The report points out that Singapore is using Sensor's Robot Smart Water Assessment Network, SWAN, to monitor water quality in its reservoirs, seeking to build smart health system and to build a smart transportation system to name a few. In this example privacy can be described as culturally rational and the rules in general could differ based on technological advancement and political arrangements. In today's networked society it is naive and ill-conceived to think that privacy is overrated and there is no need to be concerned about privacy if you have done nothing wrong. The effects of information flow can be complex and may not be simply about protection for people who have something to hide. Inaccurate information flow can have adverse long-term implications for individuals and companies. Consider a scenario where someone's computer or tablet is stolen. The perpetrator uses identification information stored on the device to access their social media page, which could lead to access to their contacts, friends and friends of their friends, then participate in illegal activities and engage in antisocial activities such as hacking, spreading viruses, fraud and identity theft. The victim is now in danger of being accused of criminal intentions, or worse. These kinds of situations are possible because of technology and network systems. Users of social media need to be aware of the risks that are associated with participation.